the grasslands. A treeless, windswept continent of grass, stretching from the broad Texas panhandle up through the mountain reaches of Montana to the Canadian border. A country of high winds and sun. High winds and sun. Without river, without stream, with little rain. First came the cattle. An unfenced range 1,000 miles long, an uncharted ocean. The southern range for winter grazing, and the mountain plateaus for summer. It was a cattleman's paradise. In from the rolling prairies, down clear from the eastern highlands, the cattle rolled into the old buffalo range. Fortunes in beef. For a decade, the world discovered the grasslands and poured cattle into the plains. The railroads brought markets to the edge of the plains. Land syndicates sprang up overnight, and the cattle rolled into the west. Population, new needs crowded the last frontier. Once again, the plowman followed the herder, and the pioneer came to the plains. Make way for the plowman. Without rivers and with little rain. Settler, plow at your peril. Two hundred miles from water, 200 miles from town, but the land is new. Thank you. disappointed. The rains failed and the sun baked the light soil. Many left. They fought the loneliness and the hard years. The rains failed them. Thank you. we really plowed the plains. We turned under millions of new acres for wool. We had the manpower. We invented new machinery. The world was our market. The new wheatland. 100 million acres, 200 million acres, more wheat. Country without rivers, without streams, with little rain. Once again, the rains held off and the sun baked the earth. This time, no grass held moisture against the winds and the sun. This time, millions of acres of plowed land lay open to the sun. caked out, blown out, and broke. Year in, year out, uncomplaining, they fought the worst drought in history. Their stock choked to death on the barren land. Their homes were nightmares of swirling dust, night and day. Many went ahead of them, but many stayed. Until stock, machinery, homes, credit, food, and even hope were gone. On to the west. Once again, they headed for the setting sun. Again, they headed west. Last year, in every summer month, 30,000 people left the Great Plains and hit the highways for the Pacific Coast, the last border. Blown out, baked out, and broke. Nothing to stay for, nothing to hope for. Homeless, penniless, and bewildered, they joined the great army of the highway. No place to go, and no place to stop. Nothing to eat, nothing to do. Their homes on four wheels, their work a desperate gamble for a day's labor in the fields along the highway. Price of a sack of beans or a tank of gas. All they ask is a chance to start over, and a chance for their children to eat, to have medical care, to have homes again. 50,000 a month, the sun and winds wrote the most tragic chapter in American agriculture.